Det gjør skid for.
Hello, art family. I wanted to put this video together to show my process on some small sketches I did for a 2-inch composition challenge my friend Tiffany Meng, who's an incredible gouache and digital painter, is hosting on Instagram. If you're not familiar with her, you should definitely find her channel and find her Instagram to find out more about this challenge. She's got a book coming out fairly soon about these 2-inch compositions she's been doing, and she's been spending a lot of time focusing on this study of doing these small compositions. And her work is phenomenal. I mean, the sense of light, the luminescence, and really, they transport you to the scene. They really make you feel like you're there. I'm a big fan of her work, and I definitely think you will be too. The challenge, as I understand it, is open to any medium, so you don't have to do gouache. I did gouache, but you don't have to do gouache if you prefer a different medium, like acrylic or watercolor or whatever. I decided to try to use this challenge. I didn't think I was going to have time, but I decided to go ahead and take the time because I've been thinking a lot about something that sort of scares me, something that I struggle with and frustrates me, and that's what I'm looking at right now, which is some rocks. I really struggle with rocks for some reason. I always end up with a weird shape. I have a hard time really pulling off rocks, so I thought this would be a good chance to really zero in on some pictures. I went on a little hike the other day in this park in McConnell's Mill, Pennsylvania, and it was beautiful. It was like something out of like a fantasy film. It was this beautiful park. There was a big mill and a covered bridge, and there were all these giant rocks everywhere, and so I took a lot of photos. I should have taken more. I'm going to have to go back soon, but I took a lot of photos of the rocks, and as I was looking at all these giant rocks, I was like thinking I need to really take some time to focus on rocks and just sketch some rocks for a while, some scenes that involve rocks or incorporate rocks into the landscape, and see what I can do about getting better about finding their form and finding them in perspective. So I thought this composition challenge would be a good opportunity for that. I still struggled with it, trying to just, especially at this size, and using a fairly large brush. That's my 3/4 inch flat that I usually use for most smaller sketches. And even though I'm used to using it, I still struggled a bit. And then I used this round brush as well to try to pick out form. I came to enjoy the sort of push and pull of trying to find the different facets and planes of the rocks to sort of section them off into their individual planes. If this one's facing towards the light, this is facing a little bit away from the light. So I really enjoyed doing it, and I felt like I got a lot out of the study and out of the practice. Also just working on composing a scene in a small space and doing a square composition, because I never do anything in a square. I've always avoided it too, so that was another reason why this challenge interested me, because it's a 2-inch square, and I have never done a square because I've always just felt like, I didn't think I'd be able to pull off arranging shapes in a pleasing way within a square. I just always felt like I don't know how I'd be able to do it. And that friend of mine, Tiffany, she does a lot of stuff in squares. She works in sort of 6x6 squares pretty regularly. And I love the way she handles her composition. She has a great eye for composition, and so I thought this would be a good opportunity for that as well, just to take some time to work out how to arrange shapes within a square and condense the value so that it is interesting and not awkward within the square. Something that interested me specifically about this scene was the yellows I was seeing in the water. You don't see it so much in the photograph, but standing there on the shore, I was underneath a bridge, and standing there, it was this beautiful, like, fluorescent yellow where light was getting scattered underneath the water, and I thought that was so beautiful and so fascinating. There was so much color happening, and you don't see it so much in the photograph, and I'm trying to bring some of that life back into the sketch. It was kind of a mistake I made. I went to this place later in the day because I had other stuff I had to get done. And so I got there pretty late. So I was able to get one watercolor sketch in while I was on the location. I wanted to do more, but I didn't have time. But I'm glad I was able to get in a small hike and take some pictures and really discover the park. It's not too far from where I live, so I'll definitely have to go back and paint there regularly, because it was just a phenomenal looking park. And this is on the trail. There's like a walking trail, and I mean, just giant boulders everywhere. And there were like tower boulders, like these really tall boulders, these rocks that were like shot up vertically, and then on the tops they had all this like tree and foliage growing on the tops. It was really fascinating and really beautiful. And there were all these old gigantic fallen trees everywhere, and light just dancing around the trail, which I loved it. And I took a bunch of pictures of the hiking trail, and basically, I mean, I could have just taken pictures walking and spinning around in place, because it was just everywhere you looked like this photograph. It was just this beautiful arrangement of trees and giant boulders, moss on everything, and then this light just sort of raking through it. It was really a beautiful trail, and I need to go back there and get more sketching done. But again, I'm dealing here with a composition. I'm trying to arrange all this information and condense it to the value. And something that really spoke to me about this scene was the arrangement of this sort of bridge that was made from the giant tree, its cast shadow, and the various giant rocks around it and their shadows, and how it made a strong dark middle. So there was like dark light, all kind of in a row. But there was this sort of like really magic light that was passing through and just hitting the tops of some areas. And I just thought that was so beautiful. Like, it was a really fascinating part of the trail. And so I wanted to make sure to take a bunch of pictures of these sort of god ray moments that were happening all over this trail so that I could sketch them in the future, because I really like that as a storytelling element and as a compositional element. Just how can I get the raking light in the scene to look that bright and feel that bright? And how can I arrange the rest of the shapes and condense those values so that'll help that be sort of support the main light action that's happening that I was most interested in? This last one was by the mill, McConnell's Mill, and there was just this, as the water went up, there's this really serene part, and I wanted to make sure I got a picture of that to sketch in the future, and so that came in handy for this challenge. I really liked that the water, well, I liked the reflection, I thought that was really beautiful, and I also really liked how the water sort of makes a trail through it. It brings you through the composition, through the arrangement. So I liked that, and then it was a matter of trying to arrange it so that not too many things hit the corners. That was something I was trying to struggle with, arranging these shapes, was trying to keep things from tangenting into the corner or into the wall, and still maintain like a good balance on the thirds in terms of the composition. Of course, in dealing with water, I really was into the reflection, but what I liked about the reflection was all the myriad of colors within the reflection, and then trying to figure out on this tiny sketch, which I usually work, I don't work terribly large, but I'm trying to figure out how on this tiny sketch to use raking with a dry brush and other sort of techniques to bring in some darks and some colors into different areas, these bigger shapes, which are microscopic on this thing. So how can I bring in more color and more interest into these shapes without daubing at it? Because I was trying to avoid, especially using the round brush, having too much of a overworked or a worked sense where you could see my hand in the sketch, too much like dabbing at it. You get these little kind of paw marks with the brush. So it was trying to rake the brush with almost no water across an area to try to bring in some color and bring in some variation in temperature without looking too worked or overworked. All in all, I had a great time doing this, and if you have time, you should definitely check it out. And even if you don't have time, I think it ends fairly soon. So even if you don't have time to be a part of this challenge online, I definitely would encourage you to take part in just doing this as a regular practice. I know this is something that I'm going to start doing myself. I had wanted to start doing some smaller compositional arrangements as a sketch study like this, and this was just a good reason to do it, to get started doing it. So I plan to keep this as a regular practice, and I'm thankful for the challenge to face a fear I had and to attack a problem that I've been thinking about a lot lately. Thanks for watching. I hope you got a lot out of it, and I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.